uniform civil code is not a magic wand for uniformity, nor will uniformity achieve national integration overnight. Introduction, you write about the article present in Constitution, Uniform Civil Code. It is the endeavor of the state according to Constitution Article 44. It is the endeavor of the state to enact Uniform Civil Code. The reasons are, two reasons. One is uniformity or equality within, and second is equality without. Equality within speaks about gender equality. Equality without speaks about inter-religious equality. Now write about Supreme Court judgments on Uniform Civil Code. What are the Supreme Court judgments? Shah Banu case, John Vallamattam case. In Shah Banu case and John Vallamattam case, Supreme Court wanted enactment of Uniform Civil Code. Uniform Civil Code is seen as a means to secularize Indian society. Secularization here means modernization of Indian society. A common code, universalization of legal system. Universalization of legal system is an essence of modern legal system. Civilization is characterized by universal legal system. So equality before law can be practiced only when there is one singular law applicable to all religious communities. At the same time, Uniform Civil Code also is seen as the power of the state to intervene in the religious laws. So there are two different interpretations. One says Uniform Civil Code is secularization, meaning one common code for all citizens irrespective of religion. The other version says secularization means the power of the state in India. Secularization means the power of the state to reform personal laws. So Article 25, Clause 1 speaks about right to freedom of conscience, right to profess, practice and propagate a religious idea, a religious belief of one's own choice. At the same time, Article 25, 2A speaks about right of the state to intervene in the secular aspects of religion, and 25, 2B speaks about how state can provide for social reforms. So, secularization in India is a different project, a unique project. It's not only meaning one singular code for all religious community, it also means the power of the state to reform religion, the power of the state to enact law to regulate the secular aspects of the religious practice. Enactment of Uniform Civil Code was deferred by the Indian Parliament because one which was seen as an integrative device should not be used for a divisive, it cannot be used for a divisive weapon. It is not a divisive wedge, it should be an integrative device. So when there is a enactment made, then there may be a sense of fear, a sense of apprehension amongst the Muslim minorities that in the name of Uniform Civil Code, the majority is thrusting their culture onto the minority. So this is an apprehension. The majority may impress upon their culture, may thrust their culture onto the minority, and that may result in dilution of their culture, and this will definitely violate their right to religious beliefs guaranteed in 25 and right to conserve their culture guaranteed as a fundamental right in Article 29. Secularization is a life, is a process which happened for centuries in the West. So what West achieved in centuries, that cannot be expected by India to achieve in overnight. For secularization to take place, first of all, there should be value modernity. And then thereafter, institutional modernity. Value should become modern. Secular education, scientific education, universalization of education will have to proceed before going for legal modernity. So the soil will have to be tilled before we cultivate the crop. This tilling of the soil took place in West as a movement called as Renaissance movement. Renaissance was a mass movement in case of West. Renaissance reached the common man in West. It led to an intellectual awakening. It helped in the internalization of the modern ethos in the mind of the masses. And thereafter, political modernity came, industrial revolution came. So this is what the path chosen by the Western society for secularization. But when it comes to Indian society, value modernity did not happen. Even if there was a Renaissance, Renaissance was not a mass movement. Renaissance was only a class movement. The appeal of Renaissance was very restricted to the literate and those living in the urban spheres. So this Renaissance or intellectual awakening caused by socio-religious reform movement of 19th century did not lead to value modernity. So without value modernity, when you introduce a legal modernity or when you introduce a common civil code, then it may not possibly bring change in overnight, because change of material forces can be very fast, but the change of value system or change of non-material forces will be very slow. And this is what the incompatibility which we are facing today, that technologically India is advancing, embracing all technological modernity, but the religious modernity or value modernity is not getting entered into the mind of the individual, because it is natural that non-material changes takes place very slowly in comparison to material changes. This lag is what is resulting in conflict, contradiction, strain in the society of India today, and that is what is manifested in the form of, even after India getting independence, after 70 years of independence also, today women will have to fight a legal battle for their entry in the Sabarimala temple.